Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today we are going to learn how to transfer any local file to S3 bucket and save the details to DynamoDB. So first thing first, you need to have AWS account, means Amazon Web Service account, and get the details like access key ID, secret keys, region name, and etc. Now you need to set up these into your environment variable, and for that you need to have AWS CLI, means command line interface. To get this AWS CLI, there are two ways. First is exe file and second one is PIP. So I would suggest the best way and easy way. If you have installed Python, then go for PIP. Otherwise you can download the exe file. And how to get that? Here it is. You just need to search for AWS CLI, and the first link open as Amazon command line. So you just need to click over here and this page will open. On the right top here the link, so you can download the installer as per your 64-bit and 34-bit, or here is the command how to get download the AWS CLI with PIP command. So PIP command will only work if you have already installed the Python. So let's see how we can install through PIP if you have already installed the Python. So I am going to open my command prompt. So I will show you which version I have installed. So I have installed the Python 3 version. So no need to go in the Python. So I am just going to exit. I just wanted to show you the Python is already installed on my computer. Now you just execute the command PIP install AWS CLI and hit enter. So now it is collecting the all the informations and files which needs to be installed. So here you can see that my AWS CLI is already installed. Now we need to set our environment variable for the secret key and access key, as they are confidential. So we cannot use these details into our scripts. So it's better to save these details into our environment variables. So how we can save these values to environment variables? So let's see that. So now I'm going to execute the AWS configure command. So I'm typing AWS configure and hit enter. Now it is asking for the access key. So I'm going to put my access key here. Hit enter. Now it is asking for secret key. So I'm going to put the access key over here and hit enter. Now it is asking for region. I am putting my region, sorry, and hit enter, and you can left this blank and hit enter. So there is no error message. So it means all the details given by us is saved successfully. Now we are going to code. I am going to open my PyCharm. So here is the my PyCharm. So now I'm going to create a new project and I'm going to name this as AWS S3 transfer and hit create. I'm going to open in the current window. So as you can see here, the Python 3 as using as interpreter. Okay, so here the project file is created. So now the first thing which we have to do, we need to import the module Boto3. So what is Boto3? You can just Google it and get the details about that. Actually it is providing the functionality of accessing the AWS. So how to do that? how to import that module, I'm going to tell you that. So just go to the file menu and click on settings. After that, you need to just scroll it down and go to the project. Here we have the project interpreter. Click on that. And on the right side, we have this icon of adding green. I'm clicking on that. Here you can type Boto3. So we got that Boto3. So what is this? Here is the description. The AWS SDK for Python. So basically it is providing the SDK for AWS. So now I'm going to click on install package. So now it is installing. In few minutes it will get installed. So as you can see, package Boto3 installed successfully. I'm going to close this window, and here it is. You need to hit OK. So for this project, Boto3 module is installed. So now we are ready to code. So I'm going to create a Python file and going to name is S3 transfer and hit OK. So here is the Python script file. So we need to first import the Boto3. So I have installed and imported the Boto3 package. Now we need S3 object. So how we can get that? So for that, I'm going to create object as S3 and equals to Boto3 dot client. So, and here I'm going to get the resource name, and here I'm going to put the resource name for which I need the object. So we need the object of S3. So I'm putting S3 and hit enter. So in S3, I'm getting the S3 object. Now we need to upload the file. So I'm going to type s3.upload underscore file, and there will be three parameters. First parameter, the file directory which we are going to upload to S3. Second one will be the bucket name, and third one the name of the file by which we need to save transferring file to S3 bucket. So I'm going to put here a file by the name S3 transfer.txt file, and this is the test file for S3 transfer script. So this text is put it into the txt file. I'm going to close this and putting here the name of the file s3 transfer.txt. Bucket name I'm going to put here. And in the third parameter, by the name for which we are going to save this file. So like I'm going to change this as S3 script.txt and save. And now I'm going to run this script. So as we are not getting any error, the result code is 0. So let's see the file is uploaded on the S3 bucket or not. So S3 bucket is this. And I'm going to refresh it. So here you can see Here is the file S3 script. And if we are going to download this, so I'm going to download this. I'm clicking over here, download. And let's see the text which I have put it here. So this is the test file for S3 transfer script. So this is the same file which I have created in our project. So if the file is in your local directory, so you just need to put the complete directory over here and it will going to upload on the S3 bucket. So one more thing, let's see if we are not going to put the third parameter as the file. And let's see and run this script again. So yes, we are getting error over here, and the error is type error, upload file missing one required positional argument as key, means third one is working as key, basically the key name by which S3 saving that file which we are going to upload. So I am going to control Z the code and save it again. So now if we are going to rerun this code again, what will happen? Let's see. So code is finished. So what will happen that the previous file, like you can see here, the upload time is 9:53:59. So now I'm going to refresh it. Now the last modified time is updated. So it means it is overwriting the existing file. How it is doing? Because the key name is the same as S3 script, means S3 underscore script dot txt. If we change this key name, like if I'm going to put 1 and rerun this script, so it will make another copy because the existing key was different. So let's see, here is the second script as S3 underscore script 1.txt. So if the key name always same, then it will replace the existing one. If it is not, then it will make another copy of that key. Now we are left with the DynamoDB, that how these details like file name, file size, and insert time or modify date, how we can save these details into DynamoDB. We will learn about this in my next video. I hope you like this video and content. If yes, please like and share. If you have any other query or need any information, you can comment below and subscribe my channel for more interesting videos. Thanks for watching. Happy coding. Jai Hind.